Thank you. Hi, Keo. Thank you for the stretch break.
Hold on. Sorry for the squeak with the microphone. Thank you for the stretch break.
Oh, it's already been 21 minutes. Huh?
It's been 21 minutes already.
Well then.
How are you doing, Keel?
Oh wait, right. I was gonna park off.
Been good. That's good. That's awesome to hear. Just came to check in. Well, I appreciate it.
But yeah, I hope that you have a good, great, amazing day. Oh, God freaking dang it. Ah! But yeah, today we're just working more on ink circles, half the fun. Flip it up.
Hi! Hi! Hi, baby. How are you?
Okay, got that done, and we are slowly getting all of this item. Who knows, maybe we'll be swapping colors to work on the left side soon.
I'm doing good, just woke up, I'm dead tired, just woke up, Well, good morning! I hope you rest- you rested well. Good morning! How was work? Mystica! Hi!
Rested as well as I could have. That's good. But hi, Mystica.
How are you doing? Hope you're doing well. Welcome on in. We're just working more on half the fun. And we are getting very close. What is this? I really don't know. I don't know what that is. At first, I thought it was like one of those ski lifts. But no, the ski lift is over here. So I'm like, what is this? It's supposed to be a vehicle, because all of them are vehicles. Like, we got a hot air balloon, we got a train, we got a bus, horse, boat. But what is this? What is this? I don't know what it is. Is it supposed to be a carriage? I don't know. I'm good. How am I? I'm doing well. Work was long. Nothing to do again because we finished our shift in like 2 hours. So the last four was nothing to do. Melting eyeball. I do love traveling on a melted eyeball. Puts me in the Halloween mood. If you know, like very, very Halloween-y. Like Nightmare Before Christmas kind of vibes.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Well, yeah, right now we are gonna work on the helicopter. Like, is that a helicopter? Because it looks like it's connecting to the ski lift. But no, there's like one space gap. For the top. Ah, no! Ah! No.
But yeah, does anybody have any plans for today? If so, I hope they go well. If not, I hope that whatever you decide to do today, it goes good, word amazing. Better take my medicine and pass out again. Okay, Mystica.
Oh yeah, are you feeling better? Are you still sick? If so, that's... I hope that you start feeling better. I hope you make a swift recovery,
Mystica. Well yeah, take the medicine, go get more rest, get hydrated, put a bit of food in your system too if you can. Still morning sickness. Aww.
I'm sorry to hear that. Again, I hope that things get better. Like, you start feeling better, Mystica. Pep, 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 pep.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- Gonna go hang with Tiglif, so I'll be lurking. Love you too, Ty. Have fun with Tig. Enjoy your lurk. Yeah, lurky turkey. Ta-da.
So the fun thing with this pattern is I get to do everything 4 times. So like this horse you see, I get to stitch it 3 more times. This helicopter, 30 more times. Everything gets stitched 3 more times.
Doing great.
Thank you, Mystica. But yeah, I did state like the other day that I don't know if I'm actually going to be time-lapsing this piece. I might actually do so just so that I can just be like, hee-hee, time-lapse. Like, I don't know. I just want to just keep producing cross-stitch content at this point because I just really enjoy cross-stitching.
And what better way than to do time-lapses of these pieces?
Same with diamond painting.
Of course, yeah!
Because it's also something that I'm just now, like, even though I've come to the realization many, many times, I'm sort of just like, no, I'm just gonna put it to fruition. Where it's like, do I enjoy games? Yes. But at the same time, I really just want to focus on cross-stitching, and I'm like,
to teach me how you set up your hand cam at some point.
Will do. I mean,
for me, it's I have a tripod and a camera.
Like, that's just my setup. Just tripod, camera, and then putting it at the right angle. And though, here's also the thing, too, is the camera that I use is a Canon T... What is it? Canon EOS Rebel T6. So the camera you might use might be different, like drastically different from mine, whether it's a webcam or something, because for me, I have to constantly unplug it, put a new battery in it, and then try to re-get that angle. But yeah, it's honestly not too hard. It's just literally, you need a tripod, or like a tripod is recommended, a webcam or a camera of some kind, and just a flat surface so that you can rest the tripod on. And the way that I have my tripod, mine's called phone.
I mean, hey, there's like many like tripod stands for the phone too,
or like some attachments that you could use. Like, I actually have one.
I have an attachment that allows me to use the phone as a tripod. Yes, I hold my camera with my phone.
It's pretty impressive. It's a balancing act.
The circus tried calling me the other day and was like, we're really impressed with your skills. But I'm just like,
I'm a streamer. I'm a different kind of entertainer. Like, you might be able to pay me a minimum wage and a constant thing, but I'd like to keep mine a bit mysterious. Like, I don't know when I'm going to get a paycheck. I'm probably going to get it within the next month or maybe in a year. I also don't know when I'm gonna get it, but I'm just gonna be happy and be like, oh my god, I made some money.
I have a stand for it, I just don't know how to hook it up and how to show like my hands.
Yeah, honestly don't know about phones too much. Because I've never actually used my phone as a tripod. The only time my
phone as the webcam.
My goodness. The only times I've really used my phone as a webcam is whenever I was in Discord calls with people.
But that's pretty much it.
Words aren't wording. The definition of the word shall change. The tripod is what you use to record, and the camera is the thing that you put the tripod on. Hippity bibbity bobbity boo. Huzzah. Jiminy Christmas. I haven't felt this alive with my words since the day I had coffee.
And that was yesterday.
Like, I haven't felt this alive since the last time I rode anything. And that was my chair, right now. It's not really much of a fun ride, it's just a question of, will I crush my toes or not? It's always the thing of, like, needing to keep reminding my head, keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the ride, unless you want your toes to be snatched. And, like, I know some drag queen's analogies, and I'm like, I want to be snatched, but I don't want my toes to be snatched too. Like, like, my toes are my toes, they're not supposed to be seen. I don't need them looking pretty or, like, blushing red as if I've just been confessed to. Like, no thank you. I'm good, great, amazing with just how I am.
But the reason I ask is because I've started scrapbooking and want to stream it at some point.
Ooh, that's awesome! That's awesome! Heck yeah! One thing I've actually thought, well actually, I guess I'm technically a scrapbooker. Not in the way that most people would think, but I'm like, I guess I technically do have a scrapbook.
In a way you are, yeah. I put all my cross-stitch finishes in a binder.
Also, I really love scrapping books. Just being like, this book, it was interesting to read.
In the shredder you go.
This book, the main protagonist was sort of clingy. Down the gutter. Like, goodbye, girl. Like,
In a shredder?
Mm-hmm. How do you think we make shredded cheese? You really think that it's authentic and actually made from dairy? No, it's just paper clippings.
The extra spicy language
just adds that extra spice to the meals. You heard about my famous mac and cheese? Yeah, it's got spice in it. Because a lot of the things that I've decided to read and was like, nope, not my kind of thing. Like, the last time I read anything that was a little bit spicy, there was a different definition for scallywag, and I'd like to just delete that. Like, Captain Hook, please take that word back away. No thank you. Mr. Shmi doesn't need any of this.
Hey.
He's got the TikTok croc ticking and talking in a different way. Oh my god.
Here's the sad thing, I really do feel like there is some, like, someone wrote fanfiction between Captain Hook and
the TikTok croc.
Like, I really do feel like that's a thing. Like, I feel like someone ships it. I'd saw.
I'd simply cry. No! Mystica, don't cry. It's okay. It can't hurt you that much. Trust me.
It'll be like a breakup. You'll get the ice cream, the sad movies, and then you'll be over it for, like, a couple of days, only to be reminded by every single thing. Like, you look at your phone, you're just like, oh, this reminds me of them.
You look at a creme brulee, oh my goodness, this was their favorite thing. Honestly,
here's the thing. A creme brulee actually would be the perfect dessert for, like, if you break up with someone or if you're going through a tragic time.
Wanna know why? Because, the hard sugar on it,
it can't hurt you that much. Obviously, this is gonna be my new hyperfixation, not
You're welcome. Hey, what can I say except you're welcome. But yeah, a creme brulee would actually be the best dessert for, like, any sad occasion. That way you can
get your aggression out by smacking the crap out of the hard, like, caramel.
And then once you get all the shards out and make a huge mess, you then get to enjoy a nice custard and be like, okay, this was actually worth it. Like, you're rewarding yourself for letting your emotions out. Like, who needs a punching bag? Who needs revenge? All that there needs to happen is a dessert. Like, peace comes first, but dessert comes afterward.
Like, or well, no.
Peace comes second after you have dessert, because once you have dessert,
you're either on a sugar high or gonna go into a sugar crash.
And if either of those happen, I hope you don't have a weird core dream. Because, Like, I don't know what was more weird, the fact that I had a sugar crash from just a cupcake, or the fact that I was playing a chess match against a, like, biblically accurate angel that tried to best me. I honestly don't know what was worse. Of course, we did have a nice conversation. But I don't really remember most of it. All the biblically accurate angels were just saying, oh, and I was just like, I agree with you.
Cassandra is one. And then we just laughed, had some tea, just went out to the shopping mall, and then all of a sudden I just woke up after feeling like I just jumped into a fountain.
And that right there, people, is just another definition of being wet and wild. Just never thought I would be jumping into a fountain, only to just hop into bed and be like, was that a fountain?
And also, if you clearly can't tell right now, I was very peaceful, but now I just decided to choose chaos. I chose mental warfare today.
Hope you all like the images that I'm about to tell you. Who's ready for some chaos? That's the hole I just stitched in. God dang it, wrong hole. I'll say that's the worst thing you want to ever hear from anybody. Them being like, oops, wrong hole. You just stare at them and you're like, what do you mean, wrong hole? And they're just like, wrong hole.
Sorry, back. Welcome back. But yeah. What?
You don't want, like, it's like the cursed word whenever you're in a radioactive place that, or like, whatever the people, like, that deal with uranium. You don't want to hear the word, oops. At a doctor's office, you don't want to hear, oh, wrong hole. You're just like, where are you exploring, Mr. Doctor? Like, I don't...
Why are you saying wrong hole? Because I poked my needle in a wrong hole.
I accidentally undid a stitch. Like I said earlier, I was peaceful. And now all of a sudden I've chosen chaos. No, I really need to make a few remake a few redeems and make a few new ones. Like, one of them I actually need to make is, like, switch projects. Where if anybody gets, like, 5k points, they can tell me, like, hey, dum-dum, put this project away, bring out something else. And I'll be like, fine, I guess I will. And then another one I might do is, like, silver story time. Last time I did a silver story time, it was a story about how I thought that, like, pretty much I thought aliens just came by into my room and tried abducting my ring light because they thought it was a baby alien. The next day that I knew, I saw, like, a kid on a bicycle just riding around with my ring light, and I was just questioning, did an alien actually come by, or did I get robbed by an actual child? I still don't know, because I seem to have memory loss from that situation.
It happened many years ago.
I've aged like fine wine. And just like fine wine, nobody wants me, so. Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with me today. I typically get like this when I have caffeine, and I promise I haven't had a lick of caffeine. I've just decided to be open, I decided to be honest. I've decided to be vulnerable. I can 100% confidently say I have not messed up on this piece just yet. I know the tragedy, a stitcher never miscounting. It is truly an amazing sight. I pretty much could cry. It's like Jujubee finally getting her first win. You want a carrot?
Good, keep drinking caffeine, be a gremlin, join the dark side.
Oh, Mystica, I've always been on the dark side. Why do you think people have never noticed me?
Oh no, you stop it.
Mystica, you stop. No, seriously, don't stop it. Like, I've always been knocking on your window, just being like, Mystica, I'm here. I'm here. And then all of a sudden, I just see your curtains, like, being shut or just no recognition. And I'm just like, wow, okay. I really thought we had something going. So you know what I did instead?
I broke into the servers just so that I could talk to you more.
And yet I still don't see you often. And it's so heartbreaking. I really feel robbed of this situation. I feel so robbed. You don't know how I feel. Like every drag race queen that deserved the win, I feel so heartbroken.
Oh, who said I was leaving?
Oh, Mystica. Oh, no. I never said I was leaving. If anything, I'm just gonna strengthen my annoyance powers towards you. And what I mean by that, I mean, I'm just gonna continue being antisocial and questioning how I even got here. Like, me? Being in this group of servers? With these people? I don't know them. I'm Scott.
By being my friend. Aww.
But Mystica, what if I want to be more than a friend? What if I want to mean something more? I want to be that annoying older brother to you that you absolutely hate.
Actually, no.
No. Not that you hate. I want to be that one person that just walks around and embarrass people. Like, here's the thing.
I am very much for being, like, prim and proper, graceful,
making sure to have a good first impression. But if people want crazy, they're gonna get crazy. And I'll make their heads explode and just make them question. Of course, this is why I have 3 restraining orders in 3 different states, but that doesn't deter me from continuing to be me.
You've seen a lot of me. Yeah, if you want to be, go ahead. My family tree is crazy. Yes.
I'll talk to the others and be like, way back when, before Mystica knew any of you. Mystica used to be an
innocent person?
I honestly don't know what happened. Something just happened. I don't know. New Year's Eve happened? I got wasted on fruit juice. I honestly don't know what happened after that. Just suddenly became 2024, and all of a sudden I just reconnected with Mystica, being like, oh hey girl,
oh hey, how you doing?
Because apparently people are calling me old now. Might as well donate some prune juice to me, because clearly I'm having some issues. Like, Jesus Christ. No, I'm good. I'm just about to, popped up in another streamer's chat. Like, wait, I know this person. This is scary.
just being like, oh, hey, I know you.
Weren't you the person that said this and did this on their streams when I was last there? Here's the thing about,
The scariest thing of becoming friends with streamers. They will actively call you out in their own chat. Just being like, hey everybody, this is the person that decided to,
sit on an egg and pretend to be an actual chicken because they were given a redeem to do so. Or being like, oh hey, this is the person that I dared to lick a light pole because I told them it would give them a bright idea. And that happened so many times. This is why I'm grateful that I don't have many clips. Why I don't have many clips of myself? Because if I did, oh boy, people would be going through a radio. I might as well just put on the clown makeup and switch to a clown PNG. Not that I would mind. I actually like clowns. I like clowning around. Just honk honk. Honk honk everybody, my nose isn't the only thing that squeaks.
I feel like if Ty is Ty, are you still listening?
Hey Ty, how are you doing?
Well, you got called out for my hot takes and thinking Kentucky was its own thing.
Huh? What do you mean by Kentucky is its own thing? I am here. Hi, Ty.
Don't mind the unhinged things I'm saying.
But at the same time, yes.
Here's the thing, too. I'm sort of scared to show this side of me because I'm just I don't know what's going to come out of my mouth. I don't know if I'm going to suddenly, say, happy birthday to someone's funeral.
Or being like, oh, congratulations for your loss. I don't know what's happening. Of course, I know someone will get a cackle out of that. Imagine if funeral homes were sort of like boutiques. Like, the moment it became Christmas time, they just put on Feliz Navidad, one of the most happiest Christmas songs, and you just have a room full of crying people just being like, oh, Jerry, he was such a good man, and then all of a sudden, just,
Feliz Navidad.
I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas.
Just starts blasting on the intercoms and everybody's just looking at it being like, we're in mourning here.
What?
Well, yeah, also,
what kind of hot takes are you doing, Mystica? Like, what the heck?
Feliz Navidad.
Also, something else that's crazy, we're already halfway through January. That's so scary. I'm so scared.
Oh no, it's gonna become 2025 tomorrow.
That's actually gonna be terrible. Like, quite literally, it's gonna feel like 2025 is coming tomorrow. And I don't like that thought. No, thank you. Time, please slow down. Let me just enjoy my... Actually, no. I am enjoying my life. What am I talking about?
I'm enjoying it right now.
Because I get to stitch, I get to be peaceful. And, like... Yeah. The only stress that I have right now is college. But at the same time... Oh, God, freaking dang it! No! Uh-oh. Rat row, Raggy.
Rat room.
I see where I messed up. Up. I messed up somewhere. Uh-oh. This is not good. Not good. I don't care about Deal or No Deal Island.
Uh-oh. I messed up. I messed up. Oh no!
I found it! I found where I messed up! Haha! Screw you, Patter! I know where I made my mistakes! One of them was being born! The other one was just here.
The box.
Where the heck am I at? Wait a minute. Ah! That's okay. There's something in G twist. Fish to the guns of the town, to the streets of the town. Come here to slay. I came here to slay. Yes, that's my scene. Typically I wouldn't like to stitch with a knot, but I can't undo the knot, so not ideal, but nothing I could do with about it.
Hi, Ty. Yes, cutie. It's somebody. I love you too.
About me now. Walk away. Don't stop caring about me now.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hi, Swizzy. Hope you're doing well.
Honestly, I'm gonna be done for now.
We are so close to finishing just to this top corner. But I'm gonna be done for now just because my left arm is starting to hurt a little bit from holding the hoop. And for being stuck in the position, but we've made a lot of progress once again. Wee-hee-hee. All of that has been finished today. So woo! But yeah. Literally, it's just that's left. And we have this done. So yay. Super happy about that. But yeah, again, we're gonna be done for now. Wrist and arm sort of hurt. Not hurts, but feels sore. Da, ba, da, ba, da. So gonna give it some time to relax and rest and all that. So yeah. And really this, like, the wrist hurting mostly happens when I'm using a hoop. So yeah. Ooh, yeah. That's good. Ooh, yeah. da 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 da. But yeah. Ooh, shall. Like, shall we raid? I feel like we shall. Ooh, shall we raid? That is the Quahan. That is the biggest question to ask right now. Da 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 da. Ba dum bum 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 ba da. Ha 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 ha. We're gonna go black sheep meat. So here is the raid command with my emote, and here it is without it. Yeah, I hope everybody has a good, great, amazing rest of the day. I'll see everybody later. Till then, bye-bye, 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 watch.